specialist on whales and dolphins, in particular the blind Indus dolphin that lives in Pakistan. I've been coming here now for 18 years specifically to study this species. So the Indus River dolphin is a very special animal. It only lives in Pakistan, so it's endemic to Pakistan and the Indus River. It's also blind, brown, it has a very long rostrum, and it's very different to dolphins that live in the sea. So with WWF, we've done a whole series of surveys to cover the whole range of this species. And the number is well under 2,000 individuals. So actually, if you think of if there were just 2,000 people left, that would be a very, very small number. So 2,000 is actually quite a limited population size. You're right, there is still a lot of unknowns about this animal. Because it's so different to dolphins that live in the sea, and it's in fact much more ancient than the marine dolphins, its biology is quite different. And because the river is so turbid, you can't actually see through the water to see what it's doing. So there's still a lot we don't know about its reproduction, about its feeding habits, about its behavior, its social life. But apart from that, there are plenty of things that we do know, and we know that the population is increasing after protection, so that's a positive thing. Be removed from the endangered species list? I think probably not. Although the number is increasing, we believe, which is an incredibly positive sign and a really big achievement. In fact, the overall picture over the last 150 years is one of decline. There used to be dolphins in the Ravi near Lahore. There used to be dolphins in the Chenab, the Sutlej, in the Jhelum, and they've disappeared from all of those rivers. And because of the irrigation system, it's not possible for dolphins to go back to those rivers. There's almost no water left. So although the numbers are increasing in the places where they're still found, the actual overall trend is for the actual range to be shrinking and shrinking and shrinking. So I think it will stay on the endangered species list for a good time to come. Endangered mammals in the world. It's one of the most endangered dolphins in the world. And the major threats are linked to the irrigation system. The construction of barrages on the Indus River fragments the habitat into small pockets. So dolphins are trapped between barrages in isolated groups. Also, so much of the water is removed for irrigation that the dry season flow in the river is so depleted that the dolphins are concentrated into very small areas. And because of that, the range of this species has declined by 80% over the last 150 years. So it's now concentrated only in the Indus main stem, which is a very big decline. They're also caught in fishing nets. Because they're mammals, they breathe air, so they have to come to the surface to breathe regularly. And so if they get caught in a fishing net, then they can't come to the surface and they drown. And the third major threat is pollution. There's many unregulated factory discharges and discharges of sewage from cities, and it all ends up in the river. And so this is becoming a drain. And dolphins at the top of the food chain, a little bit like us, are very sensitive to the effects of chemicals in the water. There's lots of things that people can do for a start. There are possibilities to go to the Indus to actually see this creature. So there are programs in Sakha and in Tonsa where people can come and visit and go out on boats and actually see this animal. And the money that's generated goes back to the communities and for research and for conservation activities. Also, water is a really sensitive political issue in Pakistan, and there are the issues that face the dolphins are very similar to the issues that face people. And most of the water comes from the Indus, and it's a finite resource, and so treating treating water as though it is precious and not wasting it is really important. And also disposing of waste wisely, so recycling